1970. Everybody's got that album, right? And wants to learn every song from it. There are some just fabulous ones. Of course, there's Layla. Not one of your great acoustic guitar songs. Well, no. Of course, it is one of our great acoustic guitar songs. But the one I want to talk about today is Bell Bottom Blues. Great, very slow arpeggio song. Not too difficult. You just have to be able to play bar chords. Notice I played a few F chords in there and an F sharp minor at one point. There was an E with G sharp in the bass. It's a bit of a stretch. So, and there's a few different ways you can play it too. We'll get into that as we get into the lesson, somewhere along the line. But most want to talk about what happens in the very beginning. You're playing a C chord and just have to keep up a steady flow of eighth notes, slow eighth notes. Now, there's a lot of discussion that goes on all over the place, including at Totally Guitars, but as to whether this should be done with all downs or alternating down and up. When I played it through there, it was a little random. I played it mostly as downs, and the question is, did that make it less rhythmic than if I alternate downs and ups all the way? So I'm just playing C here and hitting the fifth, fourth, and third strings, and then back to the fourth. I like to have people learn to play that alternating strokes because you keep a steadier rhythm when you're moving in constant motion like that. Now when it goes to an E chord, the second chord in the song is E, but we're going to hit the fifth string in the bass. So it's E with B in the bass, written E slash B. You've probably seen slash chords before. And the same picking pattern to A minor. And then with G in the bass. So there's a few, the bass is really just ascending, going from C to B to A to G through those chords, a C chord, an E chord with B in the bass, A minor, and then A minor or C with G in the bass. It's really C with G in the bass. Then we land on F. And you definitely need to hit, if you want to get the notes the way they are on the Derek and the Dominoes album, definitely got to play it as a bar, and the G is a bar. And then the main thing that we hear is this cool little lead that's beyond the scope of what I want to talk about here just today. Anyhow, I just want to touch a little bit on Bell Bottom Blues because it's a really good example of the types of lessons that we have over at Totally Guitars. So if you'd like to check some of them out, come on over. There's all kinds of cool stuff there. There's a forum where people are asking and answering questions, community where people are in user or, you know, special interest groups talking about all kinds of things. The real highlight of one of them is the being able to request a lesson and vote on what other people are doing there. So if you really are dying to see a lesson on Bell Bottom Blues, come on over there, and I think it's already on the list. So put your vote in there, because that's how we really do decide what we're going to put lessons up for. Also, there are some videos that students have uploaded in the Target Student Review channel. If you'd like to check some of those out, they're at YouTube, and they are just, this is where our students upload videos and everybody else kind of comments on them, critiques them. I take a look at them, give them some suggestions when I can, and stuff that's just available to folks at Totally Guitars. So anyway, I encourage you to come check out totallyguitars.com. A lot of really cool stuff and a lot of really neat lessons, and you can become part of the community just by dropping in.